of God upon my life. They were better people, but God decided to pick me up. I want to appreciate you for recognizing the grace of God upon my life. And I know this relationship will last. By the grace of God, I want to thank your husband. I want to thank your children. God has blessed you with beautiful girls. Not just beautiful, they know God. I've watched their life. I thank God for Joanna. She's a minister. My. I love the way she led on Friday. And today, the name I find it difficult, but that's Sasha. I love the way she danced under the Lord. She danced with all her heart and all her mind. I love God for that. You need to be celebrating them. Yeah, just thank God for your daughter. I thank God for Fumi. I call her my PA, my personal assistant in Canada. She'll be so good. She'll be so supportive. She has been there for me all the time. God will take you higher. Your expectation shall not be cut off. Praise God. My only wife, home and abroad, say I should greet you all. You know, well, anytime I say I have one wife, home and abroad, people laughed. You know, there are many pastors who have one legal wife, but they have several illegal somewhere, somehow. But me, I have one, home and abroad. Yes, I should greet you all. And my four children, 3 girls, 1 boy. They are doing marvelously well. Thank God for everyone here. I want to appreciate you for being by a woman of God, supporting her in everything. You may not see me again, but you can always have my CD. Those of you who have cars, you have your system, can play it. It's very, very powerful. The gospel of the kingdom is audio. I know some time ago when I used to go to US, I go with some CDs, video. So the pastor called me and say, over here, people don't have time to sit down and listen to video at home. They stay much more in the car and in the place of work. So anytime you are coming to overseas, convert it to audio. So that's why I did this audio, just few copies. If you're interested, you can have it. It's very, very, you have the culture of listening to the word of God in video. You just go for, you can, at the end, just go for only $5. Only $5 for one. For one. Just go for it. It's very, very important, very, very essential. Let me tell you something about CDs so that you will know. Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
Now, a man of God in Nigeria preached a message. I don't want to give my own aspect of it. Let me give somebody own aspect of it. Maybe I'll give my own later. He preached in CDs or cassettes, and the members bought their own cassettes, and one of the members, he has is what we call a store. We call it kiosk in Nigeria. He sells many things. So while he was there, he decided to play his Bishop cassette. He put it on and with the on speaker outside. So people were listening to it outside. And there was a notable madman in that area. That madman used to be so wicked. He takes knife, he takes broken bottle, he injured people. So one afternoon, this man was playing the cassette of his bishop. So there is power in the living world. Now, this madman was coming, and people were running away because he's so wicked. he can kill. And you know, when a madman injured you, you can't take him to the court because he's mentally derailed. So it was, people were running. The man was still playing his keyset. When he landed, the man was very close. He was afraid. He ran and hid himself so that this madman. But when the madman got to where the message was going on, he stood. He was listening to the keysets. And he marched directly to the man. The man was, he said, "Who is preaching?" He said, "Bishop Oyedepo." He said, "Can I hear the other side?" He couldn't believe his eye. He turned it while the message was on. The power of God hit the madman and madness disappeared. That's what God can do. People can listen to cassette. They can be blessed. They can be healed. Anything can happen. So imbibe the culture of listening to messages. It transforms lives. Praise God. I said, praise God. I hope you don't economize, hallelujah, amen, here, because I discovered that you economize them. You know, in Nigeria, we are so excited. We praise God, we shout. We make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Let me say this. God have given the vision to our pastor here. And I want you to support her. Support her to fulfill a vision. What is blessing in Nigeria church is because they support their pastor. To be a pastor is a calling. It is spiritual. It is not physical. So, I want you to value the gift of God in you. When you value the gift in her, heaven will open doors for you. In Nigeria, we know how to support our pastors. We sow into their life. We bless their life. Anytime you come to Nigeria, you will get testimonies. You will see by yourself. Don't be afraid that Boko Haram will not do anything with you. Forget about Boko Haram. Your husband will release you. Praise God. You know, we have a bad picture about Nigeria. But there are a lot of good things. We forget the good things and major on the bad. The best education people in America are Nigerians. Best. The fastest computer was manufactured by Nigeria. Today. It's in Germany. So there are good things about Nigerians. So forget about the bad ones and take the good ones. Because if you keep on thinking of the bad one, you'll not see anything good come out from Nigeria. So in everywhere there are bad, there are good, there are what, even in every family. Everybody cannot be the same. So, as we continue to imbibe good things, so please respect her. Don't equate yourself with her. Honor yourself before her. And when God blesses you, bless her. You don't wait until she tells you. Because any time you sow into her life, you are favoring yourself. That is it. That's why when I was pastoring, you see, people just... I don't use my money to buy gas for my vehicle. Yeah. I don't use my money to buy, how you call it, top up. Top up here. Don't make call. I don't use my money. The members know what to do. And the church I pastor, the women organize themselves for 12 months. Every January, a group come with their own food. February and that group to December. Because when they value God's servant, God will value you. So value her. Make her happy. Don't allow her to beg. And she will never beg. With the little you have, support her. And heaven will increase you. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. I want to thank the men and the women. I want to thank everyone. I want to thank for making my stay comfortable. I appreciate you. God bless you. Please, can we stand on our feet? I don't know how many, because 1 hour. I believe in time. Time. You know, some people believe that there was a man of God who was invited to preach in a service, and he asked them, how many minutes do I have? And they told him that as the Spirit leads. Then he said, as the Spirit leads, it's okay. He took the microphone and he said, well, I am thinking the Spirit is leading me not to preach. They say, why? He said, because you are not a robot. The Spirit of the prophet is subject to the prophet. You can't have a Savior and say, the Spirit leads. The Spirit leads you for 4 hours, 5 hours. The Spirit leads. These are lazy people. You can't walk. Amen. No matter the anointing, let me tell you something. God can do everything. He can solve all your problems, but he will not solve all. He will only solve some. He used Immaculate to solve some. He brought me here to solve some. Because if you solve all, he won't see you here again. So God wants you for fellowship. He will solve some. You'll come again. He will solve another one. You keep coming. He keeps solving. Until you go to heaven. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Let's close our eyes. Let's acknowledge the Holy Spirit in our situation, in our life. Holy Spirit, move me now. Make my heart whole again. Spirit, move upon me. Yeah. Spirit, move upon me. Yes, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, move me now. Make my heart whole again. Spirit, move upon me. Spirit, move upon me. Yes, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, move me now, touch me now, make my heart whole again. Spirit, move. Oh, all for me, yeah. Spirit, move. Oh, all for me, yes. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, move me now, make my heart whole again. Spirit, move upon me. Spirit, move. Holy Spirit, touch our hearts right now. Pull out whatever that is not planted by you. Whatever holding your people back. Whatever disturbing their breakthrough. whatever afflicting their soul by the power of your spirit. Let that yoke be broken today. Every yoke of backwardness, every yoke of setback, every yoke of the enemy, let it be destroyed by the reason of the anointing. Whatever hold every man, every woman, every boy, every girl, whatever that is ministrating against their life, against their destiny, against their age, against their job, against their family, against their life, against their heart, in the name of Jesus, pull out! Every disease, every sickness, every affliction in your bones, in your blood, in your capillary, in your bone, in your marrow, in your life, from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, disappear now in the name of Jesus. Every yoke that holds you, whatever sin, whatever affliction, whatever hand of the enemy over your life today, be broken. Let Jesus reign in your life, reign in your spirit, reign in your soul, reign in your mind, reign in your thought, reign in every part of your life. Let Jesus occupy your mind, occupy your thought, occupy your intellect and will now. Let him take over your soul. Let him take over your mind. Let him take over your spirit. Let his word penetrate into your spirit, soul, and body. Let his word bring transformation. Let his word bring renewal. Let his word bring joy and peace and excitement. Let his word bring freedom. May your eyes be opened today to the reality of his word. May your inner mind be open. May your heart be circumcised by the word of the Lord. And may the Lord do something unique in your life today. Lord, hide me behind the cross. Let Jesus be seen and heard and embraced. Cause your world to bring deliverance, to bring salvation, to bring healing, to bring joy and peace to your people. At the end, you'll be glorified. Anoint this mat of clay with the coal of fire. Send forth your world that will transform your people. In Jesus' precious name. Can I hear louder amen? Can I hear a glorious amen? Amen? Please, you may be seated. How far can you see? That what God was laid in my heart to share with you. How far can you see? We may be equal in fellowship, but we are not equal in the grace of God. We can come here together the same year, hear the word of God, but understanding differ. The day every one of us become equal, they know that the world has ended. There is no day we can be equal. Because the entrance of the world giveth light. It giveth understanding to the simple. It is the amount of the word of God that determines who you are. If you keep doing one thing every time, then you are hearing nothing. None of us here have seen God physically. But we believe he exists, isn't it? That is faith. We came here by faith. We praise him by faith. We dance by faith. We give everything by faith. What is faith then? Faith is action based upon belief, supported by confidence. Action based upon belief, supported by confidence. What is faith? Faith is believing in the ability and the availability of God's miraculous power. What is faith? Faith is when God says, sit down. Don't look for a chair. Sit down. What is faith? is a vital spiritual force that makes a mortal man to operate in the very crux of God. Vital spiritual force that makes a mortal man to operate in the very class of God. It is the faith you demonstrate that determines how much of God inside you. You can cause your faith to sit down, your faith can crawl, your faith can move. If there is no improvement in your life, then you are stagnant. You are stagnant. By faith, you can command the impossible to become what? Possible. By faith, no sickness has a right to remain in your body. Before I go into the world, how far can you see? If you see small, you get small. If you see short, you become short. If you see far, you become farther. I tell people, think big, act big, pray big, believe big. Then God will make you bigger than your problems. I am a bundle of testimony. Because I'm talking about faith now. But I'm going to the world that will change your mental capacity. Because strength is not measured by your physical status. You can see a very big, huge man. That's not to say, this man is powerful. No. Strength is measured by the mental capacity of your mind. That was why Abraham, at 95, he was a successful farmer. Old in age, but young in his ability to think. God said in Isaiah chapter 1 verse 18, come now, let us reason together. You know what God is saying? He said, come now, let us think. Let's think. Let's think it over. Pentecostals don't think today. They take everything hook, line, and sinker. Come now, let us think. The way your life is now, it's not what God planned for you. You have to have a shift. Let me just share this testimony with you. I was born with a sickness called anemia. Any medical doctor here? Anemia. What is the cure to anemia? Operation. Now, my own anemia right on my private part. There was a man staying very close to us in Ghana. Was born in Zongo Lane in Ghana. The man owned a rupture, so he can't wear underwear, no pint, nothing. He was just stuck naked like a mad person. But what is mad? So anytime we are passing, my mother will be crying. So as my son will be growing up, this eye is going to be, she will cry. I carry that eye near. Sometimes it will swell. I will use my two hands to press it. Until we left Nigeria, we left Ghana for Nigeria in 1970. To cut a long story short, my father was a preacher, my mother a good Christian. Nobody have seen God heal anybody of anemia. I have never seen anyone. In primary school, anemia was swelled. I will press it. I'll go to church with it. When I meet people, my father was poor,
My mother was poor, no money for operation. They say, the only cure, even pastors will tell me, go and look for money for operation. I became tired of meeting pastors, as let me meet the pastor of pastors. I went to the scripture. I was in secondary school in 1983. And I read Mark chapter 11, 23, 24. And Jesus said, if you can say to this mountain, be you thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, without doubting, it shall be so. I said, I got it. I read it, I got it. I ran to my mother. I said, Mama, I have seen the doctor who is going to operate me. She said, who is that doctor? I said, Dr. Jesus. She said, you keep quiet. My mother said, keep quiet. I'll be serving Jesus before you were born. There are things Jesus will do. There are things doctors will do. Don't allow people to intimidate your faith. Don't allow people to frustrate your faith. My mother couldn't believe me, but I believe. What you need to do is to doubt your doubt and believe your belief. One Sunday evening, we went to church. 1983, one pastor is late now. After the offering, he said, let us worship God. As we are worshiping the Lord, I near say, you can't worship God today. I near swell. Because anytime I swell, I'll be in pain. That time I looked at my right, I looked at my left. I remember the scripture. I lay my hand on my private part. I say, I quoted Jesus verbatim. You mountain of Anya, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea in the name of Jesus. I heard like a deflated balloon. I shake myself looking for Anya since 1983 to today. I have not seen it again. That was the end of Anya. That God is your God. That God is your God. What the medical doctor cannot do, he can do it. What your pastor cannot do, he can do it. What nobody can do, he can do it. Because he's older than age. He's bigger than the biggest. He's stronger than the strongest. He's mightier than the mightiest. He's greater than the greatest. He occupies space and time. He occupies places. He's a creator that was not created. He's here with you. He can meet your need. He can change your life. He can liberate you. Whatever holds you, when Jesus shows up, can do anything. He's the only person who can do anything, anytime, anywhere, and anyhow. You can't question him. You can't question him. So you don't know the God you serve. Since then, I know there is no situation is not equal to the task. Let me tell you something. There is no face God's face cannot face. So if you don't see well, don't blame any witches and wizards. In every family, there are witches and wizards. Yet, people are succeeding. Why is it only in Africa we see witches and wizards? Americans, they are higher witches and wizards. Yet, they are making it. In the midst of witches and wizards, the Bible says, yea, do I walk through the shadow of the valley of death, I fear no evil. You don't understand the scripture. He said, yea, though I walk. Listen. Now, you are walking through the valley. You're only walking. It's not your bus stop. As you are walking, sickness will come. Joblessness will come. Refusal of visa will come. refusal of permanent citizenship will come. You are walking. As they come, you are walking through. You are walking through obstacle. You are walking through problem. You are walking through mountains and discouragement and frustration. You are walking through. Don't allow anything to stop your walking. Because there is victory ahead of you. I walk through the valley of the shadow. Let them gather together, they will scatter together. The enemy come like a flood, but God will raise up a standard against him. For your sake, the enemy will bow. Somebody say amen. So how far can you see matters a lot. In Genesis chapter 13, Genesis 13, I love Abraham. You know, we used to sing the song, Abraham blesses are mine. Abraham blesses are mine. I am blessing the money, I am blessing the name. Abraham. We see it very much, but we don't see the blessings of Abraham in our life. Because we don't take the risks of Abraham. Don't sing somebody until you take the risk. Praise God. Praise God. Whatever I said to you happen, when you come to Nigeria, you will see it real. God is real. How far can you see? In verse 14 to 18, as I read, I'll be explaining. And the Lord said, unto who?
Abraham.
Unto who?
Abraham.
Unto who? After that Lord was separated from him. That is the crux of the matter. I'm coming to that place. But let me finish the chapter 4, verse 14. Lift up now thy eyes and look from the place where thou art, northward and southward and eastward and westward. There is a message for you here from that big part. But let all thy set and digest in that a part of it. And the Lord said unto Abraham, after the Lord was separated from him. Why is it that God didn't speak to Abraham when Lot was with him? When God called you, he didn't say it, you carry your uncle along. Abraham needed company. God didn't say, carry your uncle Lot along. I call you. Follow me. He carried Lot. Lot became excess luggage. Listen. You know excess luggage? You pay for it. Excess luggage brings you down. Lot became quarrelsome. Lot became agitator. Find, fault finding. Fault finder. Anything Abraham does, he sees fault in it. Why did must God speak to Abraham? So, because you carry a problem, problem will make you to slow down. It slows you down. There are lot in your life until you let them go. You can't see. You can't hear from God. There are people in Toronto you need to cut off from. They are the obstacle to your breakthrough. Until Abraham let Lot heaven open. May your Lot disappear for your heaven to be open. There was a church back then in Nigeria. A lady used to do evangelism and bring people to the church.
Because of the way she was so working very hard, doing the work of God, the dedicated authority to her to help take care of the church, Bible study, and other things. Listen, when God calls you, He calls you alone.
Hallelujah.
If you don't hear from God before you delegate somebody to assist you, you are on your own. After some time, this lady was not happy with the pastor, and because of that, she grew annoyed and began to do self-style evangelism inside the church. He was worshiping another fellowship. He will steal these members. Don't come here again. More than half of the church were taken away. I call such people self-style preachers. Unknowing, the pastor couldn't believe his eyes. What is happening? She will come home. After coming, she will disappear. Don't you show her face? So that nobody will know that she was the self-styled Bible busher. Gradually, the church began to go down. She uttered as a lot. The pastor went to pray. What is happening here? After much fasting and prayer, one Sunday, the pastor was in the church. I'm telling you something that happened in life. In the western part of Nigeria. On Sunday, they were in the church. A tiger, live tiger, ran into the church. People ran, haters scattered. What is happening? It didn't come for anybody. Rock came right to the altar. And the man of God stood with boldness. If you are an animal, turn back and go back to the forest. But if you are a human being, I command you, show yourself. And the tiger manifested. Behold, it was that lady. There are lots in your family. There are lots in a place of work. Cut them off. You know what Lot does? Listen. You know what Lot does? Lot acts like a rat. You know rat? When rat will be eating you, be blowing your breeze, you will know that. You say, yeah, enjoying it. After eating, when you want, it blows you. They say, yes. And you are enduring, but you are dying. That's what we call suffering and smiling. That what Lot does. When you carry Lot along, you are carrying trouble. You can't see far. You can't see properly. You'll be seeing people like trees. No matter how fanciful or beautiful how handsome Lot look like, you don't need him. If you hand over your ministry to Lot, your ministry is finished. Any day, Lot, there are people that will say they are the paronia of the church. Without them, you can't do anything. Let them go. The church will grow. So long you maintain them, you will see where. You will think that they are the financier. They pay the fattest tithe. They pay the fattest offering. And they use that one to buy you over. Church is not for sale. Anointing is not for sale. Let them go. And God will bring 10 people to take over. You can't see where you are going with Lot. You can't hear from heaven when Lot is following you. Listen, ladies, there are some girls that you make friends with. As long as you're with them, nobody will marry you in life. I'm telling you, girls you make friends with, as long as they are your friend, no man will come and marry you because there are lots. Until you cut off from them, God will not bring your husband. I'm telling you the truth. I say by the Spirit of the Lord, every law terrorizing your life, disguised as angel of light, I command them to get out.
Lot had the heart as Absalom. They have Absalomic spirit. Very sugar-coated, very sweet, very wonderful. Oh, you say this is the angel of the Lord.
There was a lady in the church I pastor. When this lady speaks in tongue, oh, you say, wonderful. Hi, this is God. Not all tongues are from heaven. Do you agree with me? There was a girl who used to decorate and make the altar, beautify the altar, and she was about to marry. And after 3 days dry fasting, this lady came to me and said, God spoke to her that this lady will soon marry, that she should take over the decoration of the altar and take care of everything. I said, that is fine. They said, secondly, God said that every Friday she should be coming to my house to wash the clothes of my children. I said, that is very fine. You know, after 3 days fasting and prayer, you won't suspect anything. Are you with me? Because God may not show you everything. I told my wife about it. My wife said, my spirit does not agree. And I told my wife, I said, you know, we don't suspect people in our home. We don't like it. If your spirit does not agree with her, what you do on Friday? Because my wife said, why only my children clothes? Why not our clothes too? So it's as okay, what you do every Friday before she comes, wash the clothes. That is the logic. That is wisdom. So the first Friday she came, there was no clothes for her to wash. The second Friday, there was no clothes for her to wash. The third Friday, it was on a Saturday. This was again when she speaks in tongues. She said, hey, God, give me this type of anointing. Don't be deceived by tongues. There are tongues that come from Lot. We don't need those tongues. We need tongues that come from above. When God comes from above, every negative tongue will give way. She cried on Saturday evening and ran to the house crying, I will confess, I will confess. I said, what are you confessing? He said, she is an agent of Satan sent to the church that my prayer is too hard. There was a time she gave me money for transport. It was a poison money to get accident, but nothing happened. See, they have tried every means. They couldn't get me. They couldn't get my wife. Then the spirit told her, the only way to succeed is to say, God said that the plan is that when she come and wash the clothes, she will poison the clothes and the children will wear it. They'll be dying one after the other. May God open your eyes. May God sensitize your sensitivity so that you can see very well. But Lot have to be dropped so that heaven will open. When heaven opened, God waited for Abraham to let go Lot. You must let go whoever is your financier who have blinded your eyes with money. Let that money go. God will give you money. Amen. Somebody shout hallelujah. And God on his verse part, he said, from the place where thou art. I'm interpreting it to this place. The new awakening church. I prefer calling it the new awakening church, not of the church, because don't make a full sentence of a name. The new awakening church, period. Or the new awakening Bible church. Anyone can go. But don't say the new awakening of the. It's a grammatic confusion. The grammar is not complete. Praise God. Don't be annoyed with me. Praise God. Now, God said, from where you are. Listen to me, all of you here. As a member of this church, God is saying, before you see very well, you don't need to go to another church. Remain here.
Greatness is here. Promotion is here. See very well. He said, from where you are.
Aya.
Where you are, there is no better place than here. You don't need to change here. It's happening there you go. It's happening there you are. You a harlot? Spiritual harlot. You've been to, in 1 year, you've been to 10 churches. You bring to the black and the blue. The bring to the those who give you anointing oil and give you handkerchief for sale and they initiate into a secret world and you begin to see demons in the night. Here, in the new and later work, he said, look where you are standing, north wall. Look to the north. Look to the south. Look to the east. Look to the west. Then he said, as far, glory be to God, for all the land of Canada, which thou seest, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed forever. All the land, as far as you can see. I told you on Friday, I'm not seeing a little place or small shears. I'm seeing multitude and big cathedral. It is what you see, you declare. What you don't see cannot be for you. As far as your eyes can see, you don't need to have it before you declare it. Amen. Yes. I was in primary school when I told my mother, I said, this suffering you're suffering to train me in school, one day I will build you a house. My mother laughed because, you know, all these children, they can just say anything. I'll buy you a little plane. I'll buy you this. She just laughed about it. But I made what I said because I have seen it in the realm of the spirit. And 2009, I built her a house. That's why she lived longer to 100 years before she died. No more rent because I saw it in the 70s. As far as your eyes can see, it is how far you see, that's how well you go. If you don't see well, you will not go well. I do tell people, when you are working for somebody, begin to think how somebody will work for you. I'm telling you something. I pastor a man, who is now a man. He was in university. He read electrical electronics. And one Sunday, I was provoked because of this poverty I saw in the church. And I said, if you want to go into business, do anything, go and print your complimentary card. Even if you don't have an office, print it and bring it next Sunday. I will provide it and God will honor it. You know, a church full of Thomas believers, Peter believers, unbelieving believers, that's why church is very interesting. There are people, let me see first. There are people that want to believe. There are people saying, oh, these pastors, that's a big, big mouth. So out of 600 members, only 2 people came out with complimentary card. One of them couldn't come with her own complimentary card, but she came by faith. She didn't have money to print one. But this boy printed competitor, I say, Matek Telecommunication. Why university? And I prayed over it. 2 weeks later, he got a contract of 900,000 Nigerian money. Because, you see, if you don't see beyond your scope, you will remain a church rat. Every day, there are people here who sing very well, but they are congregational singer. Until you convert your wonderful song into cassette and sell it, you will get money. But anytime you are singing, they will clap you, wonderful singer, but it's not bringing money to your pocket.
you are not seeing very well.
Why not convert it into music?
The world is waiting to hear your music.
Yes. Until you see above, you cannot communicate. You only remain a local champion.
May you not be a local champion. May you be an international champion.
As far as your eyes could see, where you are. So this young guy, he got the first contract, he paid his tithe. He's, you know, there are some people, when they get big money, they have not gotten in life. What they do is to buy this and buy that and make big man.
But this boy was wise. He rented a store where he can have a place for people to come. He employed his junior sister. Because if he employs somebody outside, he will pay big money. So economic wisdom. Amen. Are you hearing something? Are we together? He employed his uncle, older than him. He started.
From there,
he got another store. He got more.
He was still in university. Staying with his parents. When money came, people say, what are you sitting in your father's house?
He said, I have reason.
He said, go and rent the house.
He said, no. God is blessing me. I'm not paying the rent. If I rent another one, I will pay double. So let me remain here until the fullness of time. Wisdom.
He remained there until when he wanted to marry.
He rented an apartment.
Today, that young boy, he has built for the parents. He built a second building. He built a third one where he's staying. He no longer buy Benjamin vehicle.
The one of Yubo have finished using.
He now bought tear rubber. The wife called me one day and said, Daddy, help me thank my husband. She bought me a tear rubber Jeep as my birthday gift. Because somebody said, you don't need to have it, see it
before you have it. It's a multi-millionaire. He travel overseas, somebody going to backyard.
A young boy. Because he see. The pastor said, print your complimentary card and let God have a lay hand on it.
And today, he's enjoying money. And he also blessing me. Praise the Lord.
Praise God. For the land of Toronto, Canada, is yours. So anywhere you want to plant, anywhere you want to go, anywhere, you will succeed there. And he said, verse 16, and I will make thy seed as the dust of the earth. So that if a man can number the dust of the earth, then shall the seed also be numbered.
The blessings of the Lord has no limitation. All you need to do, turn your eyes and see. I was in the church preaching, and there was a married woman, her 6 children. She used to be singing in the choir. She used to sing very well. As I finished preaching, I was still preaching when this woman began to cry. She was crying on the ground and crying. At the end, I went to her. I said, what's the problem? He said, you just preach my life. God has given me the grace to sing. But I don't know how to harmonize my song and make it so that others will benefit from it. I prayed for her. I told the husband, give her money. She's a minister. And the husband gave her money. She began to wash record in Cameroon. Everywhere they were inviting her. Because God brought somebody to open her eyes. May your eyes be open today. There are some of you, you are not to remain here. But here is your base to shoot out to the world.
The world is waiting to hear your music. The world is waiting to read your books. You can't be teaching in school as a teacher for years, you cannot produce a workbook, a textbook. From year to year, you are not seeing very well. I spoke to a woman one day. I said, you have been teaching for years with your master degree. What time are you going for your great degree? I said, no, you have been teaching for years. What is your book to show? The woman was provoked. He said, Pastor, provoked me. She went and gathered all her books. All those, how do you call it? Isn't it we call it? Handout. All her handout, gathered it together and converted it to a workbook. And produce them and take it to a bookstore. And she was making cool money. Cool money. She didn't know that they can read her. She thought that she would just give the knowledge to the people. It is when you produce your knowledge and people buy your knowledge, they are buying your brain. Don't sit down doing nothing. You can grow anything anywhere. You must see very properly. And you must see very well. There was a girl in Nigeria. This girl. Help me use your handset. This girl have handset. And she's not working. She's not doing anything. Anytime she needs money to top up, she will meet her spiritual mother and the Lord. Please. Mom, my top up has finished. Give me money. The woman will give her money. When she finishes again, she will go and meet one day the spiritual and say, stop that. If I'm giving you money to buy top up, I'm not helping you. But if I make a way for you to use this handset and become a business person, I've helped you. The guy say, how? The woman went, bought a table, bought the umbrella, went to a place at a busy junction and put it there. And he said, stay here, Mobile International Company. Stay here. Public make call. 1 minute, you get some money. And this girl stayed there and was making money. In a day, she would make 5,000 or 6,000 in a day. She didn't know that the handset she used to make calls. And say, how are you? How are you doing? I just want to know about you. You are a foolish person. Yeah. You have no business in calling. They want to know, how was the service? You were all in the service. How was the service? How are you? Is it made for that? It's not. You become, the handset become a liability. Yeah. So become an investment. This girl stopped begging because she saw. May you see. May you see properly. May you see properly. Do you know that when you see well, a white man can walk under you? A Canadian can walk under you. Answer, yes, sir. When I went to London, I was on the train going, and one white man, a British, I just came to him and said, please, can you give me money? I quickly gave her money because I said, they thought it's only black that begs white. So white begged me. I brought her money. I said, take. Nigeria can beat them up. Yes. Let them know that we are not black master. We are black ambassador. We are created in heaven. Assemble here to dispatch to the world. You are not a stranger here. Don't let people look down on you. What they didn't see, you can see it. If they see small, see bigger than that. When they see small thing, you see bigger than that. So when they get a star, you get two. When they get two, you can get three. It is your dream. Your dream. You keep dreaming big. You keep dreaming high. You may not see it now, but wait for it. It will show up one day. I pastor a boy. He's now a multimillionaire. He's a professor now. A young boy. I pastored when he was 14 years old. He finished primary secondary school. He couldn't make all his papers. Then he said, I want to go to school to go and teach in school. And he taught. And he came to me for prayer. And when I prayed for him, I said, you are going to be a professor. He said, how? I said, I don't know. But I see you as a professor.
From then he came to me, he said, I'm no longer going to teach. I'm going to open a school. I see that there is money in it. I said, go ahead. In the church, we raised money for him in the church to rent a 3-bedroom flat to start his lesson. From that lesson, it became nursery and primary. He employed his elder brother. He employed junior sisters to become family circle, economic management, economic wisdom. He's called Professor Otuko Akpeme. Today, he's a professor. He started, before you know it, government registered. WAEC and GC and everything registered. He started having branches. I can't count the branches having today. From nothing, he saw. May you see. Don't remain with the system of this country. The system will make you a slave. The system will make you not to think. My elder brother told me, I said, how much did you buy your handset? He said, I bought $600, but I've seen, oh, yeah, I've not finished payment. I said, you are a slave. How can you be using handset? You have not finished payment and you are making guy. They don't want you to buy and pay with cash so that they will not lose your interest. They want you to always credit so that they keep on taking, whether you're working, keep on taking from you. At the end of the month, you have nothing to show. May you see very well. Don't be trapped by all this system. This system can make you not to see very well. Take a new look in the word of God. God has a system for you. You cannot pray without that. I told them, I say in Nigeria, if I want to buy a car, I give them the money and carry the car. It's not mine. Anything you have not finished payment, it's not your own. Anything happen to it, you're in trouble. If you lose your job, you lose it. Begin to think and see very well. You want to progress in life, you must take the word of God seriously and see better. Because they want you to remain a slave so that you continue to labor for them. When you are tired, you are frustrated, and go back to my country. And you go back to your country and say, what did you come and do? All these years, you came with nothing. There is no home for you here. Then you are in trouble. While you are here, you are thinking. While you are here, you are strategizing. While you are here, you are thinking, what do I do? How do I miss this? How do I do this? How do I do that? How do I become this? How do I become this? You are planning. You are thinking. You are saving. You can't tell me for all year you save nothing. You go nowhere. I believe in savings. I save a lot to solve big problems. You can't go and meet somebody. Can you help me to pay my rent? How much do you have? I have nothing. You are a fool. Don't tell anybody I don't have anything. You want 100% help? Why are you here? See very well. Be enterprising. Begin. Get ideas and bring us something. God has deposited something in you. Don't die as a slave. See beyond the slavery. God said, as far as your eyes can, then verse 17 says, arise. Don't sit down. I love that your scripture, arise and shine, for the light has come and the glory of God. It's very good. You can be singing and memorizing it, but you are not rising. Every day it becomes a monument. It becomes a normal norms. Arise and shine, for the light of God is shining upon you every year. Arise and shine, but nothing to show. Nothing to show. You become, it become a normal tradition. Tradition will kill you. Christianity is not tradition. Christianity is spirit. The life of Christ. Don't put something and let it sit in you first. Nobody believe you until you show God. When you have no God to show, nobody will take you serious. Praise God. So he said, arise. You can't be sitting down and be rising. It's not possible. Arise. Walk through the land. In the light of it. And in the breath of it. For I will give it unto thee.
The first church I pastored, there was no land. There was no place. We have to rent a place of worship. We're not having money. We have not seen 1,000 one day, but I was seeing big. Yes. They said we should go and buy a land. I said, I'm looking for an acre of land. They said, what do you be? Are you dreaming? I said, I'm not dreaming. I'm seeing reality. But you don't have money. You don't have 1,000. I don't need to have. All I need, there is no problem. There's no money problem. There's only idea problem. Yes. I have idea. I know the idea. We're looking for land. They took us one little. I said, no, my God is bigger than this place. I'm looking for something better. He said, it's only the bush. God made the bush and turned the bush to a city. Praise God. And we went to the bush where nobody is. I said, this is where we will stay. They say, am I mad? Do I know geography? I say, God knows geography. I'm not seeing bush. I'm seeing land. I'm seeing beauty. I'm seeing everything. And we bought an acre of land. People say, what is wrong with this pastor? Acre of land? Who will pay? God will pay. When God gives vision, he makes provision. When God does not make provision, he didn't give you vision. God cannot send you to Canada as a missionary and you are making the government to give you money for a flight. The government did not send you to Canada. It is God. They let God give you money for flight. Amen. If God does not give you money for flight, he didn't send you. We bought the land and paid. The man who took over from me, he said, I cannot go to the bush. That man who bought it is senseless. They changed him and that pastor came. He said, you get less? I said, yes, in the bush. I said, let's go to the bush. And today, there's a house here. There's a house here. There's a clinic here. The place is even too small. When I go there, I say, suppose I know I could have bought more land. Praise God. I didn't see bush. Don't always see, there's a lion on the way. There's a lion. I can't make it. I can't make it. Shut up. You can make it. Turn that lion to Jesus. Jesus is a lion of the tribe of Judah. Praise God. All my men, nobody has tried it before. Be the first to try it. Nobody have graduated my family. Be the first to graduate. Nobody have owned a company. We're all slaves. Don't be a slave. You can own a company. Be the first. Let people know that you are the first. Somebody has to open the door for others to enter. You will be the next person to open the door for others to enter. You can't remain in Canada and your people will be coming and you are still in one place. Break camp and see well. So that when you go back to your village, they will honor you and say, yeah, this is our daughter, this is our son. Come back home. Come and take somebody there. We can see God in you. But when you go, they say, Richard, Richard, you cannot do anything. They say, what have you been doing here? You'll be ashamed to go home because even to get the money for flight is a problem because government have withdrawn your money. May God open your eyes today. May you not just get excited, get something doing. You must break camp. You must come out of it. My wife is doing a lot of business. I'm running up. If I travel, I stay 2 months or 3 months, she's not moved. She has a different business she's doing. Money comes to her. God called me. He has not called her. Yes. So I can't call her. Ministry is sacred. Ministry is spirit. She's doing all kinds. She can't suffer. She cannot. She's even training a boy. She gets scholarship to a boy. From secondary to university. She's doing all kinds of business and God is sponsoring her. Yes. You can't be a Christian and become a poor person in a church rat. Yes. Every day you are singing, kingdom come a little, kingdom come a little. That is not scriptural. Kingdom come in power and glory. What Nigerian Christians are doing to encourage themselves, say, one day we shall be free. One day we shall, one day we shall. Free from problem, free from headache. From 1970, one day, one day.
1980, one day. Year 2000, one day, when will you be free?
Jesus said, the Son set you free. You are free today. They begin to sing defensive mechanism song. One day, when you don't want to encourage yourself, one day, be free. Don't celebrate poverty. Don't celebrate joblessness. Don't celebrate laziness. Don't celebrate lack. Celebrate the Lordship of Jesus. Begin to see ahead what you could achieve today. See it now. You will get there. Come on, stand on your feet and begin to celebrate Jesus. Rababababosha. Leke bosandalabal. Rikalabal.